The thyroid gland, which is one of the most important gland in our body, is responsible for controlling the metabolism. And all of us are seeing a lot of growing number of people encountering problems with the thyroid gland. I'm dietitian Pradnya Padde, and in today's video, I'm going to talk all about thyroid and thyroid disorders. A very warm welcome to all of you, and I hope all of you are doing good. Oh, so what is basically thyroid gland? This thyroid gland is a gland which is butterfly shaped and is found in the front of our neck and is responsible for our metabolism, as I just mentioned. The most common problems of the thyroid gland include hyperthyroidism and hypothyroidism, which will be discussed today. This gland predominantly releases three hormones called T3, T4 and calcitonin. Who controls this thyroid gland? The pituitary gland found in our hypothalamus releases another hormone called TSH, or the thyroid stimulating hormone, which goes to the thyroid gland and instructs the thyroid gland to release the thyroid hormones. These thyroid hormones then go to the cells and ask them to keep on functioning. Now, when there is a problem in this chain of command, one starts encountering problems called either hypothyroidism, which is an underactive thyroid, or hyperthyroidism, which is an overactive thyroid gland. Why this fuss? So before we talk about the toll it takes on our system, let's have a clear understanding of this word called metabolism, because this is the most commonly used word, probably without knowing its truest meaning. Metabolism basically is the rate at which our cells of the body function. So when we say that we have a good metabolism, it means that the cells of our body are functioning optimally. What happens is when we have a underfunctioning thyroid gland or hypothyroidism, it means that the levels of the thyroid hormones in our system are very low, because of which the pituitary gland secretes more thyroid stimulating hormone. So when you find that your TSH levels are high, it is an indication that your thyroid hormones are low, and hence the need to stimulate the thyroid gland more. So high TSH values are an indication of you being hypothyroidism. How will it impact you or your body? So when you have hypothyroidism, all the cells of your body start functioning slowly. When we say functioning slowly, it can mean the cells of your heart. So your heart starts beating a little slowly than others, which may cause you to feel a little tired or lethargic. When the cells of your digestive system function slowly, the transition of the food from your gut is going to be slow, and hence people with hypothyroidism may experience bloating. If the cells of your long intestine are going to function slowly, the movement of your bowels is not going to be optimal, and hence the reason for experiencing constipation when you have hypothyroidism. The bones, the cells of your bones are not going to function optimally, which means you may tend to have joint pain. When the cells, again, as I mentioned, of your digestive tract are not going to function fast as they should, the nutrient absorption is not going to be great, which means people with hypothyroidism are at a greater likelihood of experiencing nutrient deficiencies. So when your body is not absorbing nutrients, it is obviously going to take a toll on the way you appear. So people with hypothyroidism commonly experience thin hair, coarse hair, hair fall, hair thinning, dry skin, pain of the joints, brittle nails. This is how hypothyroidism and the way you feel about yourself is related. Now, when we mention that the cells of the body are going to function slowly, obviously your body is not going to burn more calories because all the cells are being lazy. Which means if your body is not going to burn enough calories, you're going to put on weight, and hence people with hypothyroidism experience weight gain. Now, when the body is not going to burn extra calories as well as it should, all those calories are going to be saved as fat, and hence people with hypothyroidism are at a greater likelihood of having high fat percentage or high cholesterol values. So this is how hypothyroidism is going to have an impact from our head to our toe. What is hyperthyroidism? Hyperthyroidism is exactly the opposite of what we just discussed, which means all our cells are trying to function very fast, and hence people with hyperthyroidism will experience heart cells that are functioning faster, which means you tend to feel the palpitations, or your heart beats faster. All of this might also make you feel anxious, nervous, because your heart is functioning faster, may make you feel burnt out or exhausted. the digestive system is functioning very fast and the body may not have enough time to absorb nutrients, or you may experience more bowel movements or sometimes diarrhea. So this is how people with hyperthyroidism are also going to have an impact on the way all the organs function. Why would one experience disorders with the thyroid gland? Now let's talk about hypothyroidism to begin with. Hypothyroidism will have multiple reasons, and the most common reason for hypothyroidism is iodine deficiency, as all of us know. And when the iodine is deficient in our diet, the thyroid gland enlarges and it is commonly known as goiter. The second reason is a very poor lifestyle, because your thyroid gland requires, apart from iodine, it requires selenium, zinc, proteins, tyrosine to be specific, for the conversion and the formation of the hormones of the thyroid gland. So if your diet is full of junk, or if your diet is not nutritious and there is a deficiency of the nutrients, of course your gland is not going to be functioning optimally, and chances of you being pushed into hypothyroidism are high. Sleep is another factor that will have an impact on thyroid gland. Just as the rest of the organs need to recover and heal at night, if your sleep is disturbed, if you sleep very late, or you sleep for shorter hours of time, or your sleep is disturbed into parts, the thyroid gland is going to be exhausted when you begin your day. Slow acting the thyroid gland is called hypothyroidism, as we just discussed. Stress also has an adverse impact on your thyroid gland, causing hypothyroidism. And last but not the least is autoimmune disorders, which means your own immune system is functioning against your thyroid gland. It's attacking the thyroid gland, not allowing it to function properly, which is often called as Hashimoto's disease. When your immune system attacks your thyroid gland, and in the response the thyroid gland functions faster, it is called hyperthyroidism or Graves' disease. Other reasons for hyperthyroidism also include inflammation and again a bad lifestyle. This was about T3 and T4. The third hormone that we discussed at the start of the video, which is calcitonin, is responsible for the absorption of calcium and deposition of calcium in the bones. So when your thyroid is not going to be functioning optimally, of course it is going to have an adverse impact on your bone health, your calcium uptake and deposition. And hence people with thyroid disorders often experience joint pain, brittle bones, poor bone density and the likes. This was all about thyroid gland, the hormones that it secretes and the impact it will have on our health. I hope you like this video. Do share it with your friends. Do subscribe to the channel if you still haven't, because we're going to come back with another video wherein we're going to talk about the foods, because there's a lot of confusion that, you know, we encounter when we're talking to people who come for consultations about what foods should we have, what foods we need to avoid, is thyroid reversible, can I lower my dosages of medicine, what lifestyle should I work on. So this is going to be the topic of our next video. So stay tuned for more. You have a good day.